Creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. Let us bow together in prayer. Let us pray. Loving God, you make all things new. We thank you for the new life that you have blessed us with through Jesus Christ. We thank you for teaching us a new way to love and to bring this new life to those around us. So, Lord, as we celebrate and as we meditate on the new life you have given to us, we pray that your Holy Spirit will dwell within us and around us. Be with us and guide our praying and our meditating. This we pray through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The scripture reading is taken from John chapter 10, verse 10. The thieves came only in order to steal, kill, and destroy. I have come in order that you might have life, life in all its fullness. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God for his word.
Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take him at his word, just to rest upon his promise, just to know, thus saith the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I prove him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more.
Oh, how sweet to trust in Jesus, just to trust his cleansing blood, just in simple faith to plunge me neath thy healing cleansing flood.
Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I proved him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. Yes, 'tis sweet to trust in Jesus, just from sin and self to cease, just from Jesus simply taking life and rest and joy and peace. I'm so glad I learned to trust thee, precious Jesus, Saviour, friend, and I know that thou art with me, wilt be with me to the end. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I prove him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more.
Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. What does it mean to be alive? To be alive is to experience the fullness this life has to offer. It involves rich experiences like a relationship with God, relationships with each other, an increasing bank of wisdom, and peace with all of creation. All of these experiences give us such a beautiful and full life. They make us feel alive. Now, have you ever watched any scary movies before? I usually don't, because those zombies and those ghosts are a little too much for me. But what if I were to tell you that there are dead walking among us? They may not be zombies and ghosts, but this is how you can tell that we have dead persons walking among us. Someone can be dead on the inside if they just cannot trust God, because they probably went through a hurtful experience. People can be dead on the inside if they were abused by the people who are supposed to love them. People can be dead on the inside if they wake up every morning disgusted at another sunrise. People can be dead on the inside. We can be dead on the inside when we are plagued with worry, grief, and depression. When we are experiencing any of these things, then we have been robbed of the fullness of life. We walk among the dead every day, not because they were zombies, but because human dignity is disrespected. Someone decided that we must pin black against white, man against woman, old against young, Hindu versus Christian, rich versus poor. And our divide and conquer mentality has led to the manipulation of power that bears the fruit of oppression and suffering among our people. Don't you see when the people on the streets are struggling for a meal? In my time spent in India, I will always be haunted by an old lady who came banging on the glass of the car, begging, pounding on that window. And I thought, wow, what a life to wake up but not live. We can't deny it. We live in a world of injustice. We live in a world of pain. But then it's strange when we read a verse like in John 10:10 that says, when Jesus says, I have come so that you may have life and life more abundantly. And John goes on to say in verse 31 of chapter 20, but these are written that you may believe that Jesus Christ is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in his name. If there's anyone who feels as though their life is not being lived to the fullest, then there are two parts of this promise that I am so excited to share with you. The first is that you may have life by believing. And this is very important. You see, in Jesus' time, your standard of living was based on external factors, your inheritance from your parents, your education, your religious experience. But Jesus changed all of this. Your ability to have a fullness of life is no longer based on how fat your bank account is, how powerful you are in society. But it's now determined by internal factors. You can have life, life in abundance, if you believe. External factors no longer control your ability to live. It is what happens in your mind and in your heart that makes you believe and experience the fullness of life. To believe in Jesus Christ is to captivate and subjugate every thought to match the mind and the wisdom of Christ. To believe in Jesus Christ is to allow your heart to be moved by nothing else except the unfailing and unconditional love of Christ. So today I ask you, do you believe in Jesus Christ? Or are you still doubting? Do you have on the mind and the heart of Christ? If yes, if you are filled with Christ's wisdom and love, then you can share in the true meaning of the abundant life, a life filled with justice, peace, love, and kindness, because by believing in this love, you will be transformed into an agent of God's love. So friends, believe. Believe so that you may have life and have life to the fullest. We also read that you may have life in his name, in Christ's name. And why is it important to mention in Christ's name? Well, John was writing to Jewish unbelievers. And do you think it was easy being a common Jew in Jesus' time? No way. Under Roman authority, you were an ant. You were disposable. You were just another mouth to feed. Under the Jewish leaders, you were an outcast, poor man, part of the working class. But here John writes that by believing, you may have life in his name. not under Caesar, not under Herod, not under the Pharisees and the Sadducees, but under the authority of love, Christ himself, we may have life. This means that in this life, we cannot let ourselves be abused. We cannot take our rights for peace, freedom, and love for granted. Christ, who has journeyed to the cross, knows of our suffering and our pain, and has paved a way to a resurrected life, a new life, a life of abundance for all, if we only believe. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, let this be good news to us all. Amen.
Let us unite our hearts in prayer. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you travel through towns and villages, curing every disease and illness. At your command, the sick were made well. Come to our aid now, in the midst of the global spread of the coronavirus, that we may experience your healing love. Heal those who are sick with the virus. May they regain their strength and health through quality medical care. Heal us from our fears, which prevents nations from working together and neighbors from helping one another. Heal us from our pride, which can make us claim invulnerability to a disease that knows no borders. Lord Jesus Christ, healer of all, stay by our side in this time of uncertainty and sorrow. Be with those who have died from the virus. May they be at rest with you in your eternal peace. Be with the families of those who are sick or who have died, as they worry and grieve. Defend them from illness and despair. May they know your peace. Be with the doctors, nurses, researchers, and all medical professionals who seek to heal and help those affected, and who put themselves at risk in the process. May they know your protection and peace. Be with the leaders of all nations. Give them the foresight to act with charity and true concern for the well-being of the people they are meant to serve. Give them the wisdom to invest in long-term solutions that will help prepare for or prevent future outbreaks. May they know your peace as they work together to achieve it on earth. Whether we are home or abroad, surrounded by the many people suffering from this illness, or only a few, Lord Jesus Christ, stay with us as we endure and mourn, persist and prepare. In place of our anxiety, give us your peace. Lord Jesus Christ, heal us. In your name we pray. Amen.
And now may Christ continue to bless you with a life that is abundant in his love and his mercy. Amen.